The mission statement of Tunica Presbyterian Church is to know Christ and to make him known. Pastor Paul Husman has had as his motivating scripture Ephesians 4:12, to equip the saints for the work of ministry. Our 7 elders and 9 deacons seek to bathe our church in prayer and oversee 120 members in a town of 1,200 and a county of 15,000. We are a mission-minded church, taking Acts 1:8 to heart as we reach throughout our community and beyond with the gospel. Through the years, our members have participated in mission work in Jamaica, Matamoros, Mexico, Salt Lake, Kentucky, Cuba, the Czech Republic, Ethiopia, Sweden, and Cyprus and Thailand through our EPC women. We have hosted several mission endeavors, bringing non-Christian Japanese students to Tunica for a week in which they were immersed in the love and gospel of Christ. The entire church is involved in praying, feeding, housing, and fellowshipping in an international mission trip without leaving home. This is especially rewarding to our older members who would never have the blessing of a mission trip without this creative ministry. In Tunica Presbyterian, called Paul Husman as their pastor in 1988, Tunica County made national headlines as the poorest county in America, with very few black families living above the poverty level. God has been at work in this community and has poured out spiritual riches and with physical relief through short-term mission work. Since the early 90s, Tunica has been targeted as a gambling mecca by major casinos. Indeed, millions of dollars have flowed into the county, yet the poverty and attendant social pathologies are as evident as ever. There is still the need for a physical expression of spiritual love. Seth Barnes, the executive director of Adventures and Missions International, gives this summary of what God has been doing in Tunica. Pastor Rodney Hibbler, who is black, and white pastor Paul Husband have a passion to fulfill the Great Commission. After attending a Promise Keepers rally in Memphis in the fall of 1996, Hibbler and Husband believe the Lord was calling them to bring all the pastors in Tunica County together to fulfill the Great Commission in this place. 5 black pastors and 4 white pastors met weekly for prayer and the study of Henry Blackaby's Experiencing God Bible study. Out of that study, the ministers believe God was calling them to bring short-term missions to Tunica County. What has happened since then? Pastors Hibbler and Husband attended an evangelism explosion clinic and became certified teacher trainers in preparation for training youth and adults in evangelism. 10 local churches joined forces in the summer of 1997 and built 100 bunk beds in one day as they transformed an old abandoned school into a mission center to house short-term missionaries. During the first week of missions, they saw 100 professions of faith as 50 teenagers from Chicago and Cincinnati ministered through Vacation Bible School and smoke detector evangelism, installing free smoke detectors door-to-door and sharing the gospel. Now Tunica Community Ministries has its own mission center in the back of a warehouse owned by one of our elders. Since our mission work began, we have had over 5,000 short-term missionaries come to Tunica County to help us show the love of Christ to the poor, the elderly, and orphaned. By God's grace, we have seen over 3,000 professions of faith in the local jail ministry alone. Race relationships between black and white have greatly improved. This past summer, we had 6 different weeks of mission activity in which over 200 short-term missionaries came to Tunica to repair homes for the poor, build handicap ramps, conduct vacation Bible schools, sports evangelism, door-to-door evangelism, and to minister to the elderly in our nursing home and the orphans at Palmer Home just outside Hernando, Mississippi. We had 2 weeks of EPC mission teams who studied Reformed theology each night after a full day's work. Our focus this summer will be to continue helping flood victims from our nearby Mississippi River. Many of our teenagers and adults helped in the evacuation of Tunica Lake residents. There are 350 households affected by this flood, and recovery is slow. Last December, two young deacons, along with Paul and his wife Dixie, were trained to teach a new evangelism explosion course called Everyday Evangelism 2, or EV2. It shortens the original 13 weeks of training to 7 weeks. Before we started our on-the-job training course on February 12, we hosted an 8-hour Share Your Faith workshop, and 33 of our members learned how to share a 5-point outline of the gospel. As a result, our people are sharing their faith formally and informally as a way of life. We plan to start our second semester next fall. Several of our members are involved in a new local church planting endeavor, an interracial, multi-generational, interdenominational church near the casinos in Robinsonville, Mississippi, to reach the unchurched. We ask that you join us in praying for wisdom as we encourage this new beginning, as well as physical and spiritual strength in the face of spiritual warfare. Please pray for wisdom for our session in leading and discipling our church family, and that we will excel still more in doing the work of the ministry and advancing the kingdom of our Lord Jesus Christ.